Utu etzave tufar, dabru davar velo yakum. Utu etzave tufar, dabru davar velo yakum, ki Immanuel. Utu etzave tufar, dabru davar velo yakum, ki Immanuel. Utu etzave tufar, dabru davar velo yakum. Utsu etzave tufar, dabru davar velo yakum, ki Immanuel. Utsu etzave tufar, dabru davar velo yakum, ki Immanuel.
Sammy.
Good evening and Shabbat Shalom, everyone. That was almost good, but I know you can do better. Shabbat Shalom! Shabbat Shalom and welcome to Congregation Beth Ahabah. I'm Rabbi Scott Nagel, also known as Ernie. This is Cantor Sarah Beck-Berman, also known as Bert. Our accompanist this evening is Jim Bennett at the piano. Our Bema guests today include Lee Katz, first vice president of our congregation, and Andy Litauer, treasurer of our congregation. And not to be outdone, not last, but definitely not least, our bat mitzvah for the weekend, Ava Rajapo! Tonight's service is different from any other service we have during the year. For tonight, we are celebrating Purim, Purim, Purim. That's right. We will also be featuring our youth choir, Kol Simcha. So, there is a lot going on. We're going to have a short service followed by our Megillah reading. So we are going to have... Where's the joke?
Yeah.
Okay. How does Moses make coffee, Cantor?
I don't know, Rabbi.
He brews it.
Oh,
that's right. Well, it's a dar. We are commanded to be happy. So we start with a joke, but we're going to all turn together in our prayer books to page 369. 369. At the bottom of the page for Utsu Eitza.
Utsu Eitza ve tuvar, dabru davar ve lo yakum. Utsu Eitza ve tuvar, dabru davar ve lo yakum.
Yeah. In honor of Ava's bat mitzvah tomorrow, I'm going to invite her up to the podium now to lead us in the candle lighting for Shabbat and the blessing over wine. And to join her for that honor, I invite up her parents, Julie and Arun Rajapa, and her brother, Kobe Rajapa. Kobe, you're not dressed in a costume. Oh, he's a gentleman. That's exactly. That is a costume for you. Excellent.
That's wonderful.
All right, we're going to light the candles. Page two.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kedishanu B'Mitzvotav V'Tzivanu L'Hadlik Ner Shel Shabbat. Praised are you, Adonai our God, Sovereign of the Universe, who hallows us with mitzvot, commanding us to kindle the light of Shabbat.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam
We continue on page 5 as Ava leads us in Kiddush. Page 5.
Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Borei Peri Hagafen.
Amen.
Amen.
Delicious. Okay, and now let's everyone wish Ava and her entire family a hearty Mazel Tov on her bat mitzvah. Give her a hug and a kiss. All right. And we want to thank Ava and the Rajapas for sharing their bat mitzvah weekend with all of this craziness and silliness. They've been good sports from the very beginning, so give them a big high five and say Mazel Tov when you see them throughout the evening. As they're taking their seats, the rest of us are going to turn to page 28. Page 28. That's my favorite page. Page 28. We're going to turn to page 28. We're going to rise together for our call to worship. Baruch Hu.
Everybody.
It's Purim indeed. All right. We turn together to page 34. Page 34. As we prepare for Shema. How many God is there?
One
God. That's right. Hear, O Israel. Adonai is our God. Adonai is one. Take a few moments of silent prayer and reflection. Please breathe on your own. It might be hard to pray with all this silliness, but we'll give us a few minutes of silence so that we can pray what is in our hearts. We dedicate this moment of worship to those in need of healing. As we turn together to our Shabbat leaflets for Misha Beirak for healing. Congregation Beth Ahabah prays for the healing Bob Marks, Seth Ginter, Neil Gleiberman, Jeffrey Teeger, John Wheatley, Charles LeBeau, Yaakov Kogan, Rivka Kogan, Colton Richard Schultz Boyd, Max Staten Parfit, David Talheimer, Doug Heidman, Rabbi Jack Spiro, Randall Markham Berman, Andrea Barnadette Bean, Lorraine Badovsky, Kathy Marks, Kendra Novi, Barry Novi, Norma Furman, Paul Balanoff, and Bonnie Kassoff. If there's anyone else here who would like to say a prayer for a friend, a family member, a loved one, anyone at all who could benefit from our prayers of healing, please share their name aloud or in your heart as I scan the room. As we pray for their healing, we pray for all those in our world who need healing. As we pray for their healing, we pray for the healing of our broken world. Misha Barak for healing in our Shabbat programs. Turn together to page 282, page 282 in our Siddurim, in our prayer books, as we rise together for the Aleinu, which is in the middle of the page, and Lee and Andy, open the ark.
We should do that one all year, right?
We
You may be seated. We've come now to the portion in our service where we remember those we've loved and lost. We turn together to page 294. And on this Shabbat, Congregation Beth Ahabah marks the recent passing of Julia Fern Beck Berman, Nicholas Troutman, Lawrence Gordon, Ronnie Williams, and Kenna Bartle. We recall the yahrzeit anniversaries of Fred Ash, Arthur J. Bassell, John Beck, Leona W. Bernstein, Ludwig Block, Brian Blumberg, John Brush Sr., William Bill Dasher, Paul Dattelbaum, Harold Eisenberg, Oscar Eisenberg, Helene Engelberg, Jack Finn, Melvin Fliegenheimer, Arnold S. Gordon, Leroy Hutzler Jr., Bertha D. Kahn, Ionel Kahn, Herbert Kaplan, Fred Katz, Simon Cummins, Rosalie Koslow, Leah Levine, Irving Lukow, Sylvia L. Mandel, Lucille R. Meyer, Samuel Jerome Michael, Louise Morwitz, Norman Morgan, Nielsen November, Jerome S. Osmiloff, Patty A. Packer, Sharon Phillips, George Pritkin, Martin Rosenblum, Perry Russ, Claire H. Seligman, W. Earl Shiplett, Nathan Schumann, Lottie Simon, Harry Spiro, Carola Talheimer, Morton G. Talheimer Sr., Philip Tishman, Marion Heller Ullman, Clarence S. Wallerstein, Gertrude Weber, Sylvia Zappler, Michael Zemmel, Irving Zahn. If there is anyone else here who's observing Shiva, the 7 days following death, Shloshim, the 30 days following death, or if you're observing the yahrzeit anniversary of a loved one's death, or if there's simply someone you'd like to recall and remember this evening, I ask you to share their name aloud once again as I scan the room. Page 294. I ask all those who are in mourning to please rise. All those who are observing a yahrzeit to please rise. And as is our custom here at Congregation Beth Ahabah, the entire community to rise in memory of all those who came before us and in support of one another always. Page 294. Together. Yitgadal v'yitgadash shemei rabah, b'yomah divrach hirutev yamlik malchute, b'chayachon v'yomechon v'chaye dekol beit Yisrael, b'agala v'zman kariv yimru amen, yehe shemei rabah mevorak le'olam olame amaya, yitbarak v'yishtabak v'yitbar v'yitroman v'yitnase, V'yit hadar v'yit halev v'yit halal shemei dekudusha b'rechu Eila minko birchata v'shirata Tush v'chata v'nechemata Damiran b'yoma v'yimru amen Yehe shlama rabba min shemaya V'chayim aleno v'al kol Yisrael V'yimru amen Ose shalom b'mroma Hu yase shalom Aleno v'al kol Yisrael Amen. May there be abundant peace from heaven and life for us, for all Israel and all the world. And let us say together, Amen. May the one who creates harmony on high bring peace to us, to all Israel and all the world, and comfort all who mourn among us. And let us say together, Amen. You may be seated. I invite Andy Litauer to the podium now for a very brief announcement.
That's it. No.
That was a good one.
And I'm the treasurer, can you believe it? Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Happy Purim to everyone here in our topsy-turvy sanctuary and to everyone watching on YouTube. Just a few announcements today before our crazy Megillah reading. This Sunday, remember...
Sunday!
Remember to come in costume to Sunday school in the morning and also on Sunday night as the fun continues with a Beach Boys-inspired Purim spiel, a musical retelling of the Purim story as you have never heard it before. Nosh at 6 p.m., show at 6:30 p.m. Can you wear too many costumes? Monday night is the official calendar date start of Purim. So we encourage everyone to come in costume to the new session of Beit Midrash classes beginning this Monday night. It's not too late to register. For more information on all the amazing events in the coming month, please see your weekly e-news and the website calendar. Shabbat Shalom, Chag Sameach, Happy Purim, and back over to you, Rabbi.
All right, well, Cantor, it is time. This was the love. It's time to dim the lights. We are transitioning now to our Megillah reading. Now, let us start our fun lights and all of our bubbles. And let me invite up all of the Megillah readers. Covey and Ava, come down for your sign duties. Everybody should be given a grogger. Let me hear you. All right, but in order to fully participate in our Megillah reading this evening, everybody's got to learn your part. So first things first, when we hear the name Haman, But then when we hear everybody's favorite uncle, yours and mine, when we hear Mordechai, we go, more. Excellent work. And now, when we hear about our silly king, Ahasuerus, everyone go like this, Adoy! Adoy! And then finally, when we get to our hero of the story, the beautiful, the brave Esther, we go, the brave. So let's try that again. Esther, the brave. Haman. Yeah. That's right. I much prefer Mordechai. More. And I think there's no one sillier than the king, Ahasuerus. All right, I think you're ready now. Who is first? Keith.
They're coming up.
Oops. All right, everyone. Pay good attention. You ready?
Our story begins over 2,000 years ago.
That's a very long time.
The Holy Temple in Jerusalem was destroyed by the Babylonian Empire, and many of the Jewish people were sent away from the land of Israel, forced to live in Babylonia. 50 years later, Babylonia was defeated by Persia. The second of the Persian kings was named Ahasuerus.
Be'adoy!
He ruled 127 provinces from Hodu, India, to Kush, Africa, the largest, strongest kingdom in the world. King Ahasuerus lived in his capital city, Shushan, and loved to party. In the third year of his reign, to show off his wealth and power, he made a tremendous feast for all the important people in the kingdom. It was a 180-day party. After that, he threw another party.
All right!
This time for all the men in Shushan, both great and small, and his queen, Vashti, held a separate party for all the women. On the seventh and final day of the party, when he was quite drunk, the king began to brag that his queen, Vashti, was the most beautiful woman in the kingdom. He commanded her to appear before the crowd in her royal crown to show everyone her beauty. But Vashti refused to appear. The king was furious and accepted the advice of his chief counselors to banish her forever.
Dun, dun, dun.
After Ahasuerus cooled down a bit, he realized that he needed a new queen. He decided to send his men from house to house in all of Persia to bring all the most eligible, beautiful women to live in the palace, one of whom would become the queen. In Shushan, a Jewish orphan by the name of Esther,
the Brave,
lived with her uncle, Mordecai.
Mort, 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 Mort!
When the king's men came to their house to take her to the palace, he said, "Do not tell them you are a Jew."
Secret agent man, secret agent man. They've given you a number and they've been waiting.
Esther,
the Brave,
was kind and very beautiful, and everyone who met her liked her. Eventually, the king chose her as his new queen. All the while, she kept her secret. No one knew she was a Jew. Every day, Mordecai,
Mort, 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 Mort,
sat outside the palace gate to wait for news from Esther.
Dobrin!
One day outside the palace, Mordecai,
Mort, 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 Mort,
happened to hear two men plotting to kill the king. He warned Esther,
Dobrin!
Who told the king. The two men were caught and the king was saved. The incident was recorded in the king's royal chronicles, but Mordecai,
Mort, 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 Mort,
received no reward or recognition.
Soon after, King Ahasuerus appointed Haman.
I say boo! I say boo!
Boo!
Yeah, get him!
As his new prime minister.
Cheers.
And everyone was ordered to honor Haman.
Boo! Boo! Boo, I say boo!
Hey, moon. Yeah.
By bowing down to him, but Mordecai...
More!
...would not listen. He was only willing to bow to God. Haman...
Boo!
...was furious. It was not enough to punish Mordecai.
More!
He wanted his entire people to suffer. He went straight to the king to complain. There is a certain nation, he said, scattered throughout your kingdom, which is different from all other nations. Their laws are different from everyone else's, and they don't keep the king's laws. With your permission, I will destroy them. I will even pay for any expenses from my own money. Ahasuerus
Adoy!
Gave Haman
Boo!
To seal the orders and decrees. Haman.
Boo!
Cast lots, Purim in Hebrew. To pick the perfect day for his decree. Then he sent out letters sealed with the king's royal ring to each of the 127 provinces in the kingdom. On the 13th day of the month of Adar, the decree said, you are to destroy, kill, and slaughter all Jews, young and old, women and children, in a single day. All their money and property will then belong to you. After the decree was sent out, the king and Haman sat down to drink, but the city of Shushan was dumbfounded.
When Mordecai heard of
heard
about the decree, he ripped his clothing and put on a sackcloth and ashes on his head as a sign of mourning. Esther,
the brave,
learned of this and asked him why. He sent her a copy of the decree and told her she must go before the king to beg him for their lives. Esther,
the brave,
replied, everyone knows it, for it is forbidden to come before Ahasuerus without being invited. If I appear without an invitation, I will be executed. Unless the king raises his golden scepter, But Mordecai said,
Mordecai!
Do not think that your position as queen will save you. If you are silent now, help will come to us from some other place, but you will perish. Who knows if you have not risen to royalty for this very purpose? Esther asked,
the brave!
Asked all the Jews and Shushan to fast and pray for her for 3 days.
Yeah. When the 3 days were over, Esther,
the brave,
went to the king.
That's me.
As he raised his golden scepter and said, what is your request, my queen? Up to half my kingdom is yours for the asking. Esther,
the brave,
invited the king,
the me,
and Haman.
Yeah!
private party that very day. At the party, the king asked again, "What is your request, my queen? Ask for anything, up to half my kingdom, and it is yours." She replied, "Come to another banquet tomorrow. Just you,
ooh,
me,
yeah,
and Haman." "And I will make my petition." "Haman."
Boo!
"Was delighted. On his way out of the palace, he passed Mordecai."
Mark!
"At the gate. His delight turned to hate. I am important enough to be invited to the queen's private parties together with the king, and that Jew refuses to bow down to me. He wanted to kill Mordecai."
Mark!
"Then and there, without waiting for the 13th of Adar, that very day, Haman..." "built a stake 50 cubits high." That's 150 feet high. "In his courtyard, he would kill Mordecai..."
Mark!
"At the very first opportunity."
That night, the king could not fall asleep. He tossed and turned and finally called for his servant to bring out the king's royal chronicles and read him to sleep. The heavy book fell open to the story of how Mordecai... ...had warned of the plot against the king and saved the king's life. What honor and reward did Mordecai... receive for this? Asked the king. "Nothing, sir," was the reply. At that very moment, someone knocked. It was Haman.
Boo!
Coming for permission to execute Mordecai.
Mark!
He was in such a hurry, he couldn't even wait for the morning. Haman! Thundered the king. "Just the man to answer this question. Tell me, what shall be done for a man whom the king wishes to honor?" "He must be referring to me," thought Haman. And said, "Let him wear the king's royal robes. Place the king's royal crown upon his head. Let him ride the king's royal horse." "And let one of the king's most noble princes dress him and walk before the horse, crying out, 'Thus shall be done to the man whom the king wishes to honor.'" "Wonderful," cried Akashvarash.
"Annoyed!"
"Hurry up and do everything exactly as you described, down to the last detail. For Mordecai..."
Mark!
"Haman." Did as he was commanded, and Mordecai...
Mark!
...was led with royal honor through the streets of Shushan, Haman
returned
home, more bitter and angry than ever. He told his wife and his friends about his misfortune. While they were talking, servants arrived to bring him to the royal palace in time for the queen's private party.
At the party, the king asked, "What is it you desire, Esther?"
Dobrey!
"Why have you invited us here? Speak and it shall be done." Esther
Dobrey!
Answered, "If I have found favor in your eyes, then spare my life and the lives of my people. We have been sold, and I am my people, to be destroyed, killed, and slaughtered." "Who is he, and where is he who would do such a thing?" yelled the king. Esther
Dobrey!
Said, "An adversary, an enemy, this wicked Haman."
Abu!
The king was so astounded and infuriated that he marched out of the room to regain his composure. Trembling and fearful, Haman threw himself on the queen to beg for mercy.
"I'm saying, baby, please have mercy on me. Take it easy on my heart, even though you don't mean to hurt me. You keep tearing me apart. Would you please have mercy, mercy on my heart?"
At that very moment, Akashvarash
Adoy!
Returned. "You dare to attack the queen in my palace," he cried. "Take him away and execute him." So they executed Haman.
Bail! Bail! I say bail!
On the stake that he himself had built for Mordecai.
Well, Mordecai.
Mark!
Became the king's new prime minister in place of Haman. Which is funny, because that kind of makes you want to say yay, but here we are. Now, it was Esther
Dobrey
and Mordecai.
Mark.
It was their turn to send out a royal letter with the king's permission. The letter said, "On the 13th of Adar, all the Jews in the kingdom are to gather and stand for their lives, to defend themselves against any who come to slaughter and despoil them. Then on the 14th of Adar, which is Purim,
Purim,
the Jews celebrated this new holiday by feasting and partying." There's also giving gifts to each other, helping the poor, and continuing to tell the story of Esther's bravery in saving the Jewish people and defeating the wicked. It's the last one, guys. Give it all you got. The blessing after we read the Megillah. Praised are you, Adonai, our God, sovereign of all, who fights in our fight, judges our cause, avenges our wrong, who brings just retribution upon all enemies of our soul, and who enacts restitution for us from those who harm us. Praised are you, Adonai, the God who delivers your people, Israel, from all foes.
Amen and amen.
So let's say one last big hip hip hooray.
Hip hip hooray. Megillah readers, Keith Fitzgerald, Will Healy, Leah Contreras, Elvis Contreras, Barbara Goldberg, Crawford Turner, Melissa Turner, Cantor, and our Megillah helpers, Sivan Rubinsky, Zach McGilgan, Matt Gaskin, Mads McGilgan, and the amazing maintenance staff led by James, who set up all of this stuff and didn't call me crazy more than two or three times. Yes, so now let us invite up all of the children for a special blessing of candy and a challah. Ava, where's Ava? Come and lead us. All the children, yeah, okay. A special blessing for the children. Yisimcha Elohim Gefrayim V'chim Anasha Yisamech Elohim Kasara Rivka Leah V'Rachel. May God make you like Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah. May God make you like Ephraim and Manasha, all of whom led forth our people in strength. And now for all of us, Yivarecha Adonai V'Yishmerecha Ya'er Adonai Panav Eilecha V'Chunecha Shalom. May God bless us and keep us. May God be with us in everything that we do. And may God grant us nothing but health, happiness, and peace. And let us all say it together.
Amen.
And now Ava's going to lead us in blessing over the challah.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam.
Amen.
All right, the kids are going to take some candy and some challah. They're going to go sit back down. I'm going to make a very, very specific announcement. Anyone who's helping out with the Purim games downstairs or the Purim food upstairs, now is the time to take your station and be ready for the onslaught, which is this amazing crowd right here. And let me tell you, everybody, right outside the back doors and down the stairs to the right-hand side, we have our Purim Carnival Games. They're being run by our brotherhood. There are prizes for everyone. You're not going to want to miss it. Games for all ages downstairs. And our Purim Carnival dinner is upstairs in the lobby featuring chicken nuggets, chicken corn dogs, Holmentaschen, soft pretzels, lots of stuff, nachos, nacho cheese. It's going to be amazing. Ice cream, ice cream, ice cream. So all of it's free and for you to enjoy and celebrate the Purim holiday. And now we're going to turn together to page 369, and call up the youth choir once again for our closing song.
Too far, the brood of Argent Lo Yakum.
Shabbat shalom and Chag Sameach, everyone! Let's go party, party, party! Come visit the Cantor and I for an adults-only beverage, Rabbi's famous Purim Punch! And please bring your groggers back to one of the bins on your way to the lobby and to the Goldberg. If you need the elevator, it is through these doors. Chag Sameach, happy Purim, everyone! Let's go party!